Greetings, insane model-loving geeks. I've got my Klingon bird of prey here, and if you've seen pictures of it from Wonderfest, you probably saw it without the lighting, because I was a knucklehead, and I went and left for Wonderfest without a wall wart, and I just had a battery to power it, and I didn't have enough batteries to keep it lit the whole time, so here it is with the lighting effect. There's the engine glow doing its thing. Pulsing every few seconds. And it's got a little twinkle in there too. You can also see the reflection on the ramp. Oh look, there's two little Klingons there. They are. You see the reflection on the ramp, and up above them you see the dome on the bottom of the warp core, which has this flickering red and blue glow. Let's take a look up in there. I'll have to lift the model. And there's the warp core up there. You see some blinking lights up there too? You can't really see up in there except a couple of blinking lights, and that's that control panel next to the door at the top of the ramp. And it's got some blinking lights coming from fiber optics that lead to LEDs. Yeah, you can see I added a bit more detail in here. There are wire stanchions here on the ramp that are holding up photo-etched railings. Maybe you can see them better now. You may also be able to see that there's detail added on the landing gear door. Oh, there you have a pretty good view of the landing gear there. It's hard for it to focus that close, but let's see if it tries to focus. There are the lights in the windows. This little navigation light on top. Headlights here. Some people call these headlights some kind of deflectors. I don't know. Out in front, again, there are more windows and navigation light on top. And there's a whole bunch of lighting for the deflector, which is that red ring, all around the photon emitter, which is lit up orange there. Let's take a look from above. And you'll see, here's some detailing that I added on top. There's a little light glowing in there. It's painted in sort of a brick red in that polygon opening there. And let's take a look in this hatch. See if we can see anything down there. Oh yeah. There's a Klingon in there. Let's also see if we can see there's a ladder coming up from the hatch. That's hard to see. It's a bit dark in there. But you might be able to see that there's lighting in there. It's got its own little control panel in there. I think you can just, you can just make out the red light. There's also just warm white lights in there that are just the lighting inside that airlock chamber. And there's a ladder going down the side that I added. Photo etch ladder. I bent it to in shape with the hull and to look like it's attached all the way down. And there's another Klingon standing right there. I really have no idea what these two little things here are on the side of the command pod, but I decided that they can hook conduits up to it when the thing's on the ground, and they run to this little outbuilding I scratch built just to hide my electronics that are on the outside. This thing normally sits on a mirror, and I didn't have a base built for it to hide the electronics, just the mirror. Well, I had no place to hide electronics, so I hid them in there. There's a bit more detailing on here I could point out. That piping on top of the engine deck is molded into the hull on the kit, so I cut that all away and replaced it with some bent styrene rod. I also put some photo etch on here. I just found some bits of photo etch that fit perfectly over these little rectangular areas on these two pieces that angle out on both sides of the top of the engine deck. And of course, back to the glowing engine parts. Everybody knows the Klingon Bird of Prey kit has that molded as one clear part, and that on the studio model, it's two separate parts. It's red on the outside, and the lower part is yellow on the upper side, so I had to cut that in two and then establish the detail that goes in on the inner sides of these two forks that come out. So that had to be added with bits of styrene stock. And that's about it. I added my own decals. There's a Klingon trefoil, whatever the heck the word is. Three-sided thing. And these markings here simply say House of Kang. I just think Kang is cool, so I let this be a ship from his house. And that's a complete view of this thing as well as I can do. I chose not to do the red bird markings on the underside. I simply continued the color palette from the upper side of the wings here on the bottom. So the only place we've got red is sort of a brick red on the interior that you see up into the landing gear bay. and elsewhere where there's sort of a primer color showing through, and of course wrapping around the command pod is this big tube for the cloaking device and some other little bits and pieces of red that poke out here and there, red or a brown or a brick red, that kind of color. That's also what I chose for the landing gear themselves. So I basically broke it up into greens for the outside, reds for the inside, and some of the red shows on the outside as well, but no great big Romulan type birds on the undersides of the wings. I've got enough of those Klingon birds of prey with the red markings on the underside of the wings already anyway. Oh, one other little change I made here. There's just like there's molding running around the hull, there's this molding along the trailing edge of the wing. And on the kit, it sticks out. I hollowed out the rear edge of the wing and then put the detail on the inside. Let's see if I can get this guy to focus on here. Focus. He doesn't want to focus there. So that's more accurate to the filming model, but it's this kit is not made up to be like the filming model. I just did a few things that are like the filming model and left other things alone. One thing I really should have done something with is the disruptor cannons here, but I completely left those alone. That's one of the things that's really screaming out for being improved, as is the depth of the hull here. That's way too shallow. That should be built out deeper so that it's about maybe half an inch deeper than what you see there. And so like the better part of the width of my thumb, how much more that should stick down. But can't do everything. So there's an overview of my Klingon bird of prey. I'm calling it done. So because I've already entered it in a contest, I got prizes for it, and I guess I shouldn't mess with it. Okay, so thanks for looking.